Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, holy lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us and not we ourselves. Amen. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. I want you to know that I'm not a preacher yet. I believe that you are not a Christian yet, and I don't have many sermonettes. So we'll be here until I get done, or until you get ready to go, amen. However, I will say, like Elizabeth Taylor said to her fifth husband, I will not hold you long. God has been good to us, amen? Amen. He has kept us safe, and we serve a mighty God. Amen. He loves every single one of us. I turn your attention to the book of Ruth. Ruth chapter 1. Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem went to sojourn in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. That will be our caption for meditation. So I invite you to bow your heads with me as we pray. Loving Father in heaven, we approach your throne of grace to give you thanks, Lord, for being so good to us. Speak to me, through me, and for me. And we will be careful to give you all the praise, the honor, the glory. May we learn something that will draw us closer to you. We ask these mercies in Jesus' name. Amen.
What chapter?
Ruth chapter 1, verse 1. Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to sojourn in the country of Moab. He and his wife and his two sons. Bet is the second letter in the Hebrew alphabet. Just like Alpha and Omega are the first and last letters of the Greek alphabet. But when it is used as a prefix, Bet, it means house of. Bethsaida, house of fish. That's where Philip, Peter, and Andrew came from. Bethsaida. Bethesda, house of mercy. That's why many hospitals are called Bethsaida, Bethesda. Bethany, house of dates, or hospitality. That's where you have two sisters and a brother. Lazarus, Martha and Mary, and whenever Jesus wanted to have a good meal, he would frequent the house of Bethany, the house of Mary, Martha and Lazarus. And Bethel, which is a contraction of Elohim, means the house of God, Bethel. The house of God. Bethlehem, however, means the house of bread. Can you say that with me? The house of
bread.
Rachel died in that area. Jesus was born in Bethlehem. And Micah gave his prophecy hundreds of years before Jesus was even born. He not only said that it would be a son, but he said where he would be born. in Bethlehem Ephrata, or Ephrata as we call it. And he not only named the town, but he named the province where Jesus would be born. He was very precise, very exacting. We have Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, Bethlehem this, Bethlehem that, but he named the town and the province Bethlehem Ephrata, where Jesus would be born. And the message is entitled Bethlehem, the House of Bread. You see, Bethlehem had built its reputation in the fact that there had never been famine in the land. There was always bread in Bethlehem. There were large granaries in Bethlehem. And there was enough food to feed entire cities. If you were famine stricken, you could go to Bethlehem and there you would find substance that would stick to your ribs, that would stick to the walls of your stomach. People went to Bethlehem to be fed. And I believe that you need to go where you are being fed. There were large granaries. Entire nations, if they would have money, they could go to Bethlehem and they would buy grain. They would buy food, bread, to feed entire nations. Bethlehem, the house of bread, is a place where you can find barley and wheat, bread. But in Ruth chapter 1, we just read verse 1, there is an oxymoron mentioned in the same sentence. A certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to sojourn in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. The reason why Elimelech and Naomi left Bethlehem, there was a famine. But Bethlehem means house of bread. How can you mention Bethlehem and famine in the same sentence? It's an oxymoron. How come there was famine in the land of bread? And they went to Moab to be fed. Elimelech and Naomi with the two sons, Mahlon and Chilion, and they spent 10 years there in that land of Moab. How amazing that they went to a hidden land. Now, I want you to know, a friend of mine, that when they went to Moab, Moab were descendants of incest with Lot and his daughters. And there were people who hated God. There were people who, when Israel was leaving Egypt, the Moabites did not give them any kindness. As a matter of fact, they were, of all the nations that opposed Israel, they were the most adamant in their opposition. They hated Israel, therefore it means that they hated the God of Israel. But they had bread in Moab. And Elimelech died, and his two sons, Mahlon and Chilion, married wives of Moab. And as time went on, the both sons died. They married Orpah and Ruth. And Naomi said to her daughters-in-law, after the time transpired, she heard that there is a visit from the Lord in Bethlehem, and there is bread in Bethlehem. I'm going back to my country, to my people, to my land. And she entreated her daughter-in-laws to stay here with your own people and your own culture. And and Oprah decided to stay, and that's where we get the name Oprah, and that's where we get the name Oprah. And Ruth decided that she's going to stay with Naomi. She said, your God is going to be my God, your people is going to be my people. I'm going to lodge where you lodge. I'm going to live where you live. She made a transition to change camps because she recognized that Naomi was very special. She made her way back to Bethlehem and she got married to Boaz. She gleaned in his field. And Boaz begot Obed, and Obed begot Jesse, and Jesse begot David. And he looked through that lineage. As a matter of fact, Boaz was a descendant of Salmon, who got married to Rahab the harlot. And Jesus, if you read the genealogy, Jesus came through that lineage. God is no respecter of persons. You could have been a pagan, an idol worshiper, but if you exercise faith in the God of Israel, you were grafted in and you were considered an Israelite, even though you were not an outward ethnic Jew.
Amen.
God loves us, what do you say?
Yes.
If we be Christ, we are Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise.
Amen.
What promise? The same promise that God gave to Abraham, renewed to Isaac and to Jacob. God is a God who loves every nation, kindred, tongue, and people. He wants everyone in his kingdom. All men can be saved.
Yes.
But all will not be saved because all do not choose the God of Israel. Amen?
Amen.
God is a mighty God, what do you say?
Amen.
Bethlehem. Place where Jesus was born. Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, a place of bread. But when Christ came on the scene, one writer said that he was born, but whatever they believed and whatever they taught, Christ went against the grain. And when he spoke, the conclusion was, never yet man spake like this man. He spoke with authority, he spoke with conviction. Christ's teaching was different. Christ was a revolutionary. His teaching was different. He made people feel important, he made people feel special, that they were unique, that they were valuable in the sight of God, that they were special, that they had meaning to life. I'm saying this to say that Christ is the true bread of life.
Yeah.
He is the water of life. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is not just a way, definite article. He is the way,
Amen.
The truth, and the life. Apart from Jesus, there is no other way. There is no other truth. There is no other life. Jesus is
Amen.
All that he claimed to be. He is the true bread. When you come to Jesus, as he said to the woman at the well, if you drink of this living water that I will give you, it shall be in you a wellspring of water springing up into everlasting life. He is the water of life. He is the bread of life. If you have found Jesus, you have found everything.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
He is all that he claimed to be. Jesus forgive sin. No other religious leader upon the face of this earth never made the claims that Jesus made.
Amen.
He claimed divinity. He said, before Abraham was, I am. And as high as you can go in the Jewish mind, Jesus claimed to be deity. Before Abraham was, I am. And the Jews took up stones to stone him because he claimed to be God. The Bible tells me that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. And without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life. And the life was the light of men. And the light shined in darkness. And the darkness comprehended it not. Amen?
Amen.
There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came to be a witness of the light, of that light. He was not that light, but he came to be a witness of that light. That was the true light, amen, which lighted every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world. The world was made by him. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave him power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And verse 14 says, and the Word became flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Light dispels darkness. Light shines brighter when the darkness is thicker. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus is the light of the world.
Amen.
He is all that he claimed to be. He forgave sin. He accepted worship. He said, me and my Father are one. He claimed to be the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. He is the bread of life. Amen.
Amen.
No other religious leader upon the face of this earth never made those claims. Because he is all that he claimed to be. If God is who he claimed to be, serve him.
Amen.
And if Baal be your God, then worship him. Amen. There is no sitting in the fence. You and I cannot be on both sides. Amen.
Amen.
Christ says, if you're not with me, automatically you're against me. As a matter of fact, what I'm trying to say, friend of mine, we don't make a decision to be lost. We are born lost. We are born separated from God. We are born in the pit. We don't make a decision to be in the pit. We have one decision in this life, and that is Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
If we fail to choose Christ, we automatically remain in our lostness. Something is wrong with our first birth. All of us have been born bad. As soon as we are born, we begin an inexorable march toward the grave. As soon as we are born, we begin to die.
Amen.
We are born lost. Life is in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
He that hath the Son has life. The house of bread. We are living in a crisis situation today. And I want to remind us that in the time of storm, in the time of thunder and lightning, sheep tend to huddle together.
Yes.
Read between the lines.
Yes.
If the train has come up the track and there's a broken path in the rail, the welder comes and he welds that rail together, and the molecules come together, should there be another tragedy, that spot that is welling will never break.
Stronger. Amen, brother. Preach it.
So some of us, if the rail have come up the track, we need to put it back on and keep moving. This church is the movement.
Amen.
We are born for glory.
Amen.
We got to move with it.
Amen.
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 God loves us. He wants us in the kingdom. If we cannot contend with the footbear, how can we, if we cannot make it an open country, how can we contend with the horsemen? If we cannot make it when the Jordan is low, how can we make it when the Jordan overflows its bank?
Amen.
We have the bread of life. We have the water of life. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
God loves us. Amen.
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 It's a time when we need to come together.
Amen.
Someone said that he was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up yet in another village and worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. Then for 3 years, he was an itinerant preacher. He never wrote a book, never had an office, never had a family or owned a house. He never went to college. He never visited a big city. He never traveled for more than 200 miles from the place where he was born. He did none of those things one usually associates with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was handed over to his enemies. He went through a mockery of a trial. He was crucified between two thieves. And while he was dying, his executioners gambled for his clothing, the only property he had in all the world. And when he was dead, he was laid in a barred grave through the pity of a friend. I'm saying to us, 2,000 years have come and gone, and today he remains the central figure of the human race and the leader of mankind's progress.
Amen.
all the armies that ever marched, all the navies that ever sailed, all the kings that ever reigned, all put together have not affected the life of man on this planet as much as that one solitary life.
Amen.
Jesus is who he claimed to be. Amen.
Amen.
Napoleon, while he was in exile, said to one of his generals that Jesus is the most influential person who ever walked upon the face of this earth. He said that Charles the Great, Charlemagne, the Kaiser, and even Napoleon himself, he said that all our names will be forgotten. All of us have tried to rule the world based on arms, by force, and more recently Adolf Hitler. But he said that Jesus have conquered the world based on love.
Amen.
By his birth, the calendars changed. Because we have AD, we have BC and AD, amen? Jesus is the most influential man who ever walked upon the face of this earth.
Amen.
Mahatma Gandhi, that great Indian leader, read the Sermon on the Mount every single day.
Amen.
He said if Christians would live like the Christ of the Bible, all India would become Christians.
Amen.
He said, give me your Christ, but keep your Christians.
Amen.
What a powerful message.
Amen.
Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. He is the bread of life. He is the water of life. There is bread in New Smyrna.
Yeah.
And I believe that when people come here, they should be fed.
Yeah.
You need to go where you are being fed. As long as you speak and pray, thus say the Lord. There is sustenance here in this world that will stick to your ribs.
Yeah.
That is food for your mind. That will stick to the walls of your stomach. We need to go hungry. We need not shy away from the disaster and for the perils and for the calamities that is coming upon the face of this earth. We need to stand up and be counted.
Amen.
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 God loves us.
Amen.
I want you to know, friend of mine, I came from idolatry. I came from paganism. I was an idol worshiper. But when I discovered the good news, I came from an East Indian community. I brought disgrace to my entire family and to the community. Do you know what it's like holding a Bible in your hand and walking the streets, passing the temples that you used to go to and going to church, and having evangelistic meetings in my same community? Because I've been there, telling them that I found a new way in Jesus. My friends ridiculed me. But you see, I've discovered something that they didn't know. I was just a beggar telling another beggar where to find the bread.
Amen.
In Jesus. And I told him I didn't write the letter. I'm just a mailman delivering the mail. God loves us. Amen.
Amen.
He wants every one of us in this kingdom. And I've preached in many evangelistic series. And they have been protesting on the streets. But the word of God never falters nor fails. The word of God never returns void unto him. Despite the opposition, despite the crisis, God always prevails. At the end of the day, friend of mine, I don't care what people think about me. All I'm concerned about is what God thinks of me.
Amen.
And if God be for you, who can be against you? What do you say?
Amen.
When I came into the church, the enemies were all there in the world. Turned out the enemies within the church. Within. God does not change. You might say, brother, be old fashioned. God is old fashioned. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore.
Yeah.
My God does not change. Remember last week's message?
Yes.
God changes not.
Amen.
He loves us. He wants us in the kingdom, friend of mine. And one of these days it's going to be alright, what he says.
Amen.
One of these days, we're going to swing by those pearly gates and those glittering hinges. We're going to walk on the streets of gold. We're going to stand on the sea of glass. We're going to sing that welcome song. Amen?
Amen.
One of these days, there ain't going to be no more sickness.
Right.
No more pain, no more sorrow, no more crying, no more eyeglasses.
Hey, praise God.
No more wrinkles in our faces. No more false teeth and no more gray hair, no more arthritis, no more cancer, no more hospitals, no more Ebola.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
No more prisons. No more hospitals, no more debt. The undertaker will have to find a new job. Amen. All those doctors and nurses will have to find a new career, because no one will get sick, what is it? We're going to eat from the tree of life. We're going to sit at the welcome table. I'm looking forward to the day when Jesus will come again, when a trumpet will sound and the angel will shout that Jesus is coming again. Amen. I want to be that number when the saints go marching in, what is it? Let nobody steal your joy. Amen. Let nobody take your crown. John 14, Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. You don't go to the grocery and purchase your grocery and left it on the counter. You take it with you. Yes. When Jesus came the first time, he came at the appointed time. When he comes the second time, he's coming back with catastrophic suddenness, ready on that. Here I come. He's not going to leave what he has purchased. He's come to take his home with him. God loves us. We are special. We are important. We belong in a palace. We don't belong in the boonies. We don't need to be a slave to sin or the devil. We belong to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. What do you say?
Amen.
I want to be there when Jesus comes again. Amen. It's not important only how you live. It's important how you die. And precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of the saints. Amen.
Amen.
I hope that you have been fed. Amen.
Amen.
This is a house of bread.
Amen.
Amen. And there's plenty good room in my Father's house. Amen.
Amen.
God loves you, friend of mine. What a day that will be. Hold on. Hold on to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
He is coming again. I know what it's like, friend of mine, being out in the streets. I know what it's like having your own way and being a rebel, getting into fights and laying up in the hospital beds many times. I know what it's like doing drugs and having your own way. But I found the water of life. I found the bread of life. And if Jesus can do it for me, he can do it for you.
Amen.
If I have to get sick, I've been in the prison ministry for many years, over 20 years in South Florida. And when I get into the prison, some of the men have done it, don't have any hygiene. And when they open their breath, their mouth to speak, their breath can knock you out. And for all those years, I've never got sick. It's festered with AIDS. But God accompanies his people when they're on his errand.
Amen.
Amen. He never leaves us alone. Amen.
Amen.
So we are not to fear. We are not a coward in the fear of danger.
Amen.
The time of crucible, when the crisis comes upon us, we need to hold on to Jesus. Where will you go? Where else is the bread of life? Bethlehem,
Amen.
The place of bread, the house of God.
Amen.
Shall we bow heads as we pray? Father in heaven, thank you for your grace and your mercy, for your kindness, for your keeping power, for being so good to us. Keep us faithful unto you, dear Lord, and as we face another day, another week, the time ahead, we face it with the full assurance that you will be with us. You may not take us out of the trouble, but you will be with us through it all. But we'll arrive safely on the harbor. Because the hymn writer says, swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Keep us faithful unto you, be it our wives and our children, our loved ones, our friends. May they embrace the knowledge of Christ. Those who are outside the faith, may they embrace the knowledge of Christ before it is eternally too late. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Love our closing hymn.
I love it when a man prays and can feel his prayers.